Hello guys, and welcome to this new Blender tutorial. Today we will practice how to make a drone without any reference image, just something from our imagination. So let's begin with the cube. Let's delete the light and the camera, and let's scale this something like that, maybe. Yes, and grab this edge here, this edge to the back a bit, something like that. Now, important thing to apply scale, otherwise we will have troubles. Go to edge, select this one, and let's bevel it, maybe 8 segments, something like that. And while at the edge, or maybe just select this face and resize it to the x-axis, something like that. Select edges again, all the edges here. Let's make a shell here, just something close. This one the same, and this is it. We don't need any more stuff. Basically, this I will make it as simple as possible. Now add a path, to see it better let's add some geometry to profile. Try maybe 0.25. The cap's resolution is 12 to have a cleaner shape. Rotate z-axis minus 45, and send it inside something like that. And let's grab this one. Now, if we move it, as you can see, we cannot move it the same side it's pointing at. We need to go to local and then work it out, as you can see. Something like this is okay. Then we might press E to extrude, then right click, don't move it. Then another E and go maybe something like this is fine, I guess. Let's go and add a mirror modifier, select our cube and do this. So this is basically what we have now, same as this, but remove one. Rotate x z axis 45. Go to top view and keep it at the same distance, and just go to edit mode, grab this one and move it like this. So this is as simple as that. Now go to edit, grab this one here, extrude, and let's see what will happen. We send it down. We can use those as a base. or just to give it nice interesting shape. So we'll just keep it like this for now. This is fine. This is our main body, and those are the fans holders or the rotor holders. Now let's add okay, before we add something, let's just go to top view. Instead of moving things, just go to this one here and shift, right click, and we will have the cursor here. This will make things much easier. Now go to add and let's add a cube. Resize it and size it down, bring it up a bit, apply scale, go to this face, extrude size. This will be a fan part, so more, and I think this is fine. If it's a bit big, we will resize it later. And now, if you feel that it's a bit thick, just resize it to the Z axis, something like that. Now, grab the face we made. And with the proportional editing, just rotate to the Z axis, as you can see. But make sure you rotate all of it, not only the tip part. Something like this will be maybe okay. We don't want to rotate the base, so I think this is okay. Yeah, now let's go add subdivision. As you can see, maybe it will be okay. Let's check it out. It's supposed to be smooth. And we need to array or mirror it. Let's try with mirror, yeah. But the problem here that you can see that this part is going higher than this part. When we mirror it, it will get the same. So you don't have the shape of a fan. Instead of that, what we can do is go here, make an array. Of course, we need to add an empty here, go to array, subject, object offset, choose the empty, remove this one and click the empty and just rotate 180 maybe. Rotate Z axis, no, Z axis 180, 0. And as you can see, we have this kind of fan, so it's fine. And let's apply those guys. Remove this empty, we don't need it anymore. Now we need to mirror this. Click on mirror object here and do this. We will have all four. Of course, we will need more here, so let's duplicate, bring it to the middle here. Of course, we don't need the Y mirroring, and do this, set it on top of the handler. Now of course this is not enough, we will have to do more stuff for those. Coming back here and add a cylinder, something like that. This is too big. Yeah, this size is okay, size it a bit. Now also we need to mirror this. Let's see. Yeah, for now we don't want to put those there, we will do it once we finish its modeling. Shade smooth, of course, for all the pieces. You go here, as you can see, we go to edit mode, and Control R to add a loop cut, then Control B to bevel it, something maybe like this, remove or disable the proportional editing and bring it up here. Of course go to face selection and press E, right click, then with Alt S we need to resize those a bit down. This is okay, don't worry about those, this is the handler, we will bring those things up a bit, so it's okay. Go to edge here, we need to chamfer it to make it look more interesting. And before we do that, let's just bring those up and select the cylinder and apply the scale. Go to edge mode, select this edge, chamfer like that is good. Then select those inner edges here and here, and let's bevel it with 8 segments maybe to make it nice and smooth. Then select the outer ones here and here and here, and chamfer with 1 segment. Yeah, this is the difference guys between the fillet and the chamfer, that it's a 1 segment bevel, may give you this curve, it's like a 45 degrees edge. Now this is fine, I guess. Maybe we can just bring this thing up a bit and resize something like that. It's not bad. Now we need to duplicate, send it to the middle, remove the eye from the mirror. We didn't apply the mirror. Be careful, once you apply the mirror, you will have to deal with each cylinder by itself if you want to change something. So don't apply it unless you are sure that this is what you want. Bring it up here, and this is supposed to be okay. Now it's not, we will have to move it a bit. I think we need to go here and grab the top vertices point, and with Alt S just resize it like that. The same for this one, because it looks a bit big for the cylinder. Go to edit mode, grab this one, Alt S, and resize that point. And this is what we have. I think it's fine. Now if we go here and apply this mirror, Let's see what will happen. No, don't apply it yet. Go here and rotate to the z-axis. We just want to give it some shape and make it look more interesting. We don't want to keep things lined like that. So this is fine, I guess. Maybe we go to this one to rotate the way you see fit. It's a personal preference. Nothing is required. So basically this is it. Now this is fine. Let's do something else. I think the main thing is done here. We need to put some bases so this can land on, like a chopper landing gear or something. Let's add, I like to work with paths. Curved paths are cool, but before we do this, let's just reset our cursor with Shift S. Go to cursor to world origin and click. Then let's add a path. Bring it down like this. And we know we need to rotate 90 degrees. Of course, let's add the geometry so we can see what's going on. I think 0.15 is okay for now. We might need to fix this later, but for now, let's keep it like that. Now move this to the side, bring it a bit down. Or what we can do is keep it at its place, because we will mirror this, so it's okay. Go to edit mode, grab this one and the last one, press E, right click, then E, and extrude to the top. And is this gonna be the landing gear of this drone? We try to make it as big as possible, something like this maybe. Bring it down. Now let's bring it to the side and select those ones, and of course we have a problem because this is too much, I think. Let's size it again and bring it in like this, and we take those. Maybe we bring those down a bit and bring it like this. Maybe we will see. Let's mirror this. I think the drone is a bit small. Something like this is fine. Maybe they are a bit too thick. Let's try 0.12. Maybe this is gonna be solid steel, so it's okay. Let's see. Maybe we need a bigger face here because we will need to add some stuff. Let's try to extrude or resize to the x-axis. I think this is going to be fun. Now, let's make some cuts to the main body. First, let me check before making anything. This is fine. With this cube. Edit Boolean tools and let's make slice. Something like this. So this here, bring it a bit more, something close, bring it to the front, and this is to be our camera, just to imitate that it's a camera. We don't need to have full functioning functioning camera here. With the vertices, local view, just delete those ones. I think we here, it's a good cut, it's okay. Okay. Let's grab those or maybe let's do something else. Maybe something like set the cube, bring it down. just mirror it, so we might need to edit. Okay. Let's remove the mirror. The cylinder. Okay, we need a better cylinder. Just add the cylinder and set it to 64 vertices. And bring it down, rotate it to the x-axis 90 degrees, and start. What the hell? Apply rotation and scale, then resize to the y. This is a bit big. Something like this is fine, I guess. This is our missile, which will, which this drone can fire from the air. So bring this one, duplicate, send it to the back here. This is our missile holder, so it's fine. Now for the missile, let's start. Extrude, resize. Extrude. Now resize, or maybe not, just keep this one for now. And this face we need to let me try to apply this. Because I want to try to bevel this whole face. Yes. Something like this. Go to edges, grab this edge, bring it back a bit. This is fine, I guess. This scene, guys, is just for practice and for render if you want. So nothing will be functional. Now go here. It looks fine, but weird. I don't know. Okay. The cube, bring it down and resize. Rotate Y 45. Bring it while selecting global, bring it down. Something like this. Let's add an array and let's work this out easy way. shift, right click to put this cursor here, then bring this in here, rotate 45, then size the y-axis. We need a thin piece like this, then let's add a radial array here, make it 4 segments, something like this, apply, rotate 90 degrees, bring it in, go to vertex mode. Something like that. I think it's fine, maybe a bit thin. I think it's okay. Okay, let's try to put some materials on. Let's add some light. Okay, we'll make things fast, guys, so you don't get bored. For the main body, let's have this kind of black. I think we missed something here, but it's fine, you can fix it. Now for those guys, add something more shiny. for this one, we need to add a glass shader. Maybe like this is fine. Those guys are metal. The rocket is the fun part. Go to faces and select those faces. Set to materials here, new, assign those faces to the second one, because this is gonna be our glass. For the first one you can just put whatever you want, it's up to you. I would keep it maybe a bit gray. Maybe I will add one more, make it like blue, and select those ones, assign, select this one, assign, and select this one, assign. Yeah, something like this. It's up to you, the way you want the missile to look like. Same for those. Add some materials. Now let's check how this look like. Now why this blue didn't work? Sign, yes. Yeah, it's up to you guys, to be honest. Now basically this is the main thing. Sharpen. What else you can do? You can, of course, those ones also will need some materials, maybe one, or maybe this one. Of course, you can play with the materials and see how it fits. So this is our assassination drone. Inside the plane, make it 30, bring it down like this, give it some material, this, maybe. Set the camera. Lens is 70 millimeters, like this. Of course, it's too much close. Something close like this is okay. Let's render. Now, of course, guys, this is considered like blocking out. If you want to make good looking, this main thing is fine, but you need to work out the finest smallest details. Like I would add decals here, I would make some cuts and panels in the main body, so to make it look more interesting. For now, and for the sake of this video, I want to keep it short, so I hope you like this video. Please subscribe. If you have any question, guys, please leave it in the comment and we'll be glad to answer it. And we'll see you in the next one.